I'm Craig Kenneth, a relationship coach and a psychotherapist. Every relationship is different and every breakup is different. Work with me and you'll get professional help on your situation. And if you're in no contact, focused on personal growth, my workbook series, The Knowledge, will help you make changes like you've never made before. Available now at AskCraig.net. Hi there, I'm Coach Craig Kenneth.
I'm Coach Margaret.
And today we're going to be talking about It's All My Fault. Well, I think one of the hardest things about going through a breakup is feeling like it's all your fault.
Absolutely, yeah.
And one of the things that you immediately do is look at everything that you did wrong, even if it wasn't really wrong, but you're interpreting it as wrong.
Everything. Well, people will read me things they said and say, was that it? Was that it? No.
There are so many different reasons why a relationship can end or fall apart, and it's really quite normal to immediately look at the situation and assess, what did I do wrong, because you want to repair it. Because if you think you know what you did wrong, you think you know what you could fix.
Right.
Right? Which makes sense to me, except you're so overwhelmed with anxiety and depression, you're not thinking clearly, and you're probably focusing on things that really weren't the relevant reasons.
Right.
Now, part of that is because I find that in most cases, the person isn't really truthful about why they're breaking up with you.
Right. That's a real problem.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
They give you hints. There are often hints, but it's generally because there's a reason that they don't want you to know. So, like, if they are attracted to somebody else, in most cases, they're not going to say, hey, I met somebody else and I want to date them. Sometimes people will do that. Sometimes they'll hide it and then they lead you on a wild goose chase.
Yeah.
Now, I have found that I find that avoidant people tend to throw spaghetti on the wall and see whatever sticks. Because if they have you focused on all those different things, then it keeps you really away from solving the real problem. Because if you were able to solve the real problem, then they might have to work it out with you. But if they say it's the problem is A, B, C, D, E, and you're looking at A, B, C, D, E, and they're like, none of these even make any sense. Well, it's probably because they just said it.
Or the old, it's not you, it's me.
Yeah.
Because, or I can't be in a relationship right now, I have too much going on.
Exactly. Because
yeah.
if they said the problem is really X, Y, Z, then you could say, well, let's work on X, Y, Z. Well, if they're trying to escape, it's like they're throwing a rock and you look at the window and to see where the distraction is.
And sometimes they don't know.
Yeah.
They know something's not working. They decide perhaps it's you, so they'll toss you out and see if that makes things any better for them.
That's
true. Rarely does it work.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Yeah, sometimes, I mean, there's a lot of different reasons people do it. Maybe they're just unhappy with their life and they think, well, maybe it's the relationship. Let's try that. I need to, you know, a lot of times people are like, I need to move. And they think that if they move, they're going to magically feel better.
That's called the geographical cure,
mm-hmm.
named by the substance abuse people years ago. Yeah,
really?
The old geographical mm-hmm. cure. If mm-hmm. I move, I can start again and everything will be okay.
Yeah, and it doesn't work like that. Right? Because
yeah.
it's about your internal state
sure.
and what you're going through.
And you can't leave it behind no matter how hard you try. It will come with you.
But you're going to sit there and think about everything that you did wrong and beat yourself up and say, if I had done everything different, I would still have this person. Well, there's no saying, you know, that that's true. You don't know if that's true. Even if you had been perfect, that doesn't mean you would still be together.
Sure, things happen.
Mm-hmm. It's just a variable you can't see, you know, yes, this is truth. Is it possible that if you had made less mistakes, you might be together? Sure, it's possible, but that's not a guarantee.
No, it's not.
Okay? So I've got a good success story that somebody emailed today, and they were feeling a lot more positive about the breakup.
Good.
So we thought we'd share it. They said, hey, Coach, I have a success story. My ex-girlfriend and I have been broken up for 3 months. Which was a very nasty situation. She pinned the entire relationship failure on me and making me feel like everything was my fault.
Oh, dear. How terrible.
Yes, because when you love somebody and you're really wanting to work it out and try and make things right, and then they have you feeling like it's all your fault, well, that's kind of a way of keeping you at arm's length, right? They can control the situation if they say, well, this is all your fault, because now...
So it's not my fault that I decided to leave you and go with three other people. It's all your fault for making me do this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And when somebody has you believing that it's your fault, you're like, well, just give me another chance. No, I can't do that because I don't feel the same way anymore.
Mm-hmm. And that's all your fault.
Yeah. But it's not a mature way of handling things, and that's not how an adult would act. An adult would say, look, we both made this relationship together. We both made our mistakes. We feed off of each other through the entire relationship. And it just didn't work out.
Yeah, and don't ever be willing to take all the blame. I think the adult stance would be, I will take my share of the blame, but that's what I'll take. I'm not taking any part that was yours.
Yeah.
So don't even try it with me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They wanted on to say, my mental health was draining me, and I experienced tremendous amounts of separation anxiety, which drove me insane. I felt extremely hopeless.
Oh.
I started looking up breakup advice and fortunately came across your channel. Since then, I've been watching your videos and got myself all 5 volumes of The Knowledge, which I have officially completed.
Wow, that's a big job.
Yeah, they are
good
a lot of work.
You.
Good job.
Yeah.
The only reason I took so long was not only because of finishing my degree, but also because I kept re-watching the videos and reviewing my answers so the information can stick. That's incredible.
Good for you. That's motivation.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I have gained a ton of insight about myself, my ex, my family, and my friends. I have recently been diagnosed with generalized anxiety disorder, depression, and an anger issue, which I have been going to therapy for, along with working on cognitive behavioral therapy workbooks to better manage these issues.
Okay.
At first, I was obsessed and even stalked my ex on social media by making a fake Twitter account since I'm blocked. But all that stopped once I started on the workbooks.
Good.
I even started writing poetry again, reading books,
wonderful,
and spending time with old friends. Old friends, is she talking about you?
Probably. How old were they?
Oh, she didn't say ancient friends.
No.
Craig, you and Margaret have made this breakup process much easier for me and helped me stay focused on self-investment. I learned that it was not all my fault.
No, of course not.
But it was also my ex's fault for the breakup. I am learning how to love myself and become a better partner, either for her or my future relationships.
Good.
In addition, I have also learned to be a better friend, co-worker, and person overall for all areas in my life. I'm excited for the Knowledge Volume 6 through 10 to be released, as I will be the first person to grab them.
Oh, that's wonderful.
And they are very far along. I've been working very diligently on those for the last 6 months. It's been a very slow progress on that, but there's going to be some exciting content that comes along with that.
I'm so glad you're excited, because it should be exciting to grow. That's wonderful.
Yes. She said, thank you, and Margaret, for your superb expertise, knowledge, and kindness. Everyone remember, regardless of how bad your situation is, there is always hope. Never give up and keep working hard. I will be sending you another success story in the near future.
All right. We'll look forward to it.
And we love to get success stories.
Oh, yes.
Because regardless if you get back with an ex, you can make yourself a success story.
That's right.
And that is what you got to remember.
And it sounds like you've done an enormous amount of work. Not a little, not in the middle, an enormous amount of work.
And you've started to now realize that the breakup was not all your fault. Through the clarity, through the work, through learning about relationships, how to treat a partner, you probably, you know, realize your ex did a lot of things to mistreat you, ignore you, neglect you, and you probably had overlooked those things and never thought about them before.
And to say it's all your fault is a really kind of mean manipulation.
Mm-hmm.
And when we're feeling that bad, sometimes we'll take it. Yeah, she must be right, you know? Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I just feel like when somebody says, this is all your fault, it's certainly not coming from a mature adult place.
No.
Because anybody who's acting reasonable would realize that every interaction between the two of you, you would have both created that together. And to think that it's all one-sided, one way or the other, is ridiculous. I mean...
Yeah, and I'd be surprised to hear that your partner has grown as much as you have.
Oh, there's no way
no.
the ex has grown as much as she has.
No.
And that's one of the things that's so incredible about breakups, is that even though you're the one that's feeling powerless and devastated and hurt, you're the one that's going to outgrow them. You're the one that's going to make all the incredible changes and transform yourself in your life. They're not.
Nope.
They're going right. to, if you bump into them and it doesn't work out, you're going to see, man, they're not looking so good.
Nope.
They're not looking right. They look.
I've grown beyond.
Dark circles under their eyes. They look unhappy. Meanwhile, you have done tremendous amounts of work on yourself. And now you're ready for something
right.
that's good and healthy. And if it's not going to be them, that's okay. Because you have used this to better yourself and better who you want to be.
Right. Good job. Thank you so much.
So great success story. And I'm happy to see that you're no longer feeling like everything is your fault and you're responsible for the breakup. You know?
Right. That's good.
I think that's an important transformation
mm-hmm.
when you're going through the breakup, is getting past that point
right.
where you're sitting there just day in and day out looking at everything you've done wrong and scrutinizing it
right.
and getting to the point where you're like, you know what?
You're making yourself crazy.
Yeah, I made mistakes and I wish I had done these things differently, but
yeah.
look at all these things
I
they did.
I didn't do all of it. Right.
This is not all my fault.
Right.
That gets to a place where you're feeling more free.
Absolutely. Yeah, you're not carrying that burden anymore.
Exactly.
It's all
exactly.
your fault. No, it's not.
So, for those of you guys out there that feel like it's all your fault, it's not.
Probably not, no.
I mean, the chances of it being all your fault are like, what, 1%?
Yeah,
really.
About that, yeah. Yeah, and you never accept that. What you say is, I'll own my share of what I have to own, but not all of it.
Absolutely. So when you guys have success stories that you want to share with us, we absolutely love to hear them. I try and pass them on to Margaret when I get them, and she reads them too and
absolutely.
Takes a look at them.
Yeah.
Of course, when you want to get our help personally, just go to my website, askcraig.net. Sign up for the coaching option that works best for you. I do email coaching and I do Skype. Margaret is also available for Skype coaching.
Please feel free to sign up with me. I can get you in fairly quickly for the next couple of weeks.
Absolutely. Put a like on the video and be sure to subscribe to the channel. But that's it for this video. I'm Coach Craig Kenneth.
I'm Coach Margaret.
And we will talk with you soon.